talk about the actual All-Star game in San Jose as we crash the net with what is trending. The results are in from the last men in ballots. We'll start with Gabriel Landeskog, elected to take the final spot in his division.
So we get all three Avs on that great line going to the All-Star game together, I guess, fitting. And a nice ad campaign by the Avs as well to help with the voting.
I think it helped. I think it went a long way. Elsewhere, Leon Draisaitl will go to his first All-Star game. He's got 54 points in 44 games this season.
The big rig, Leon Draisaitl there with Connor McDavid. The 1-2 punch that is pretty much the Edmonton Oilers. After that, pretty big drop-off. But the big German Draisaitl gets in, well-deserved.
In the Metro, Chris Letang, having a good season, takes the final spot on that roster.
Yeah, I'm happy for Chris Letang. He is playing very, very well this season. Kind of a little bit of a bounce back year, but one of the terrific players in the league, so it'll be good to have him out there.
And in the Atlantic, it's Jeff Skinner with 42 points in 43 games on the season. He reps the Atlantic.
29 goals, second in the NHL. If you can skate like that, 3-on-3, with his dynamic abilities, he deserves it. Look at that's sensational to watch. And what a year. The resurgent Buffalo Sabres. Jeff Skinner, a big part of it. Glad he got in, and Skinner will be fun to watch in the All-Star game.
And here's a look at the stats of the four last men in winners, all having great seasons for their respective teams, but some very deserving players still left off the list. And just because of the format, we knew that was going to happen no matter who won the ballot. Who are you most disappointed to not see going?
I'm still not just most disappointed to not see Mitch Marner, and he wasn't even in the last voting. But, you know, he's the guy for me that has just been so terrific this year. Would love to see him in the 3-on-3 format. And you never know. I mean, guys can get hurt. He still could get added to the mix. But that's the one for me. And I'm kind of surprised with the voting in the Atlantic. I give the Sabres fans a lot of credit. They went out and voted for Jeff Skinner, who certainly deserves it.
Yep.
But I thought it might be either Braden Point or Morgan Riley. In the end, it's Jeff Skinner. All three were deserving. Skinner gets to go. Here's the numbers. And
I'm going out west with Giordano.
Yeah.
He has a chance to be in the Norris Trophy conversation.
Yep. As does Riley.
43 points, all those guys. And those, you can make a pretty good team of players left off the All-Star team that might go there and actually win the All-Star game. So there's a look at Giordano and been leading it on the defense for the Flames. That team can put up a lot of goals, and you can't put up goals if you don't have those defensemen that can push the play, that can quarterback the power play. And that is Mark Giordano in Calgary.
And how is he going to get that San Jose SJ Sharky mug?
Each, we've been working together too long because you took the thought right out of my brain and spoke it. I might have to send SJ Sharky an old message on Twitter and say, you got to hook up our boy Gio.
That's right.
Little Gio, really.
Yeah.
With the shark mug.
That's right.
He needs one.
Right. And you described it so well. Perfectly on the show the other day.
Yeah, I know, and you're never going to let me forget it, are you?
Probably not.
You know, nobody's perfect, Ege.
No, listen, take it from somebody who knows that. Believe me, you know, on an endless basis. But, I'm surprised. Giordano, he would deserve to go, too. But you said it, Jackie. The format is such that you can't have everybody, and so we are in the situation we're in.